So we're all here to learn about public speaking, right? Everybody's interested in that, that brought all of us, we have that in common, right? So what is it exactly that you want to speak about? It's probably different for all of us. Sometimes the biggest challenge in writing and developing your speech is thinking about that all-important decision of what your topic should be. So what I'd like to talk to everyone tonight about is choosing a topic. I have a few strategies to offer for how to select a topic, and two specific buckets to choose from for where to get those topics from. The two sources that you can draw upon, and these are very, very broad sources, are personal experience or reference material. So I'm going to start out and talk a little bit about some ideas that come from your personal experience. What do you know better than your own personal experience? What topic are you more comfortable with than what you have been through? What experience you've had? This is a rich arena of ideas that have the potential to be unique and original. We have all had different experiences. If you tell a story about your life and your experience, it is automatically original because it happened to you. Other people might have something in common with it, but that's your experience, and that is going to ring as original when you give that speech. So there are four areas of personal experience that we can pull from. The first is your interests. We're all interested in all kinds of different things. Some people really like to watch TV. Is there a television show that you recently saw that was so great and it made you think and you couldn't stop watching and you had to see it and then it was 2 o'clock in the morning and you were going for one more episode? Is anybody in there? No, just me. I'm the only one? No, that's lies. What books have you read recently? Were they good? Would you recommend them? Was it a garbage book that you slogged through and you got to the end and you're like, oh, I'm so glad that's over? You should probably tell people and warn them against reading that book. That is a speech topic in itself. Where have you traveled? What are your hobbies? What do you do? There's so much in your life to share with other people. There are so many speech topics just in the things that you find interesting. Other people probably find them interesting too. The next arena of personal experience that you can pull from is your career and what you do professionally. There are a lot of things that are very specific to specific industries and specific professions. However, there are a lot of underlying ideas professionally that can carry and that can make sense and that can help other people in other industries with new ideas and new concepts. So in your career, are there specific ethical standards with your business? Are there financial topics like budgets and taxes and plans for your retirement? Or, if you're retired, what's that like? You know, that's a whole topic as well. The next area of personal experience that we all share and have to speak on is family. Tell us about your ancestors and the generations that came before you. If this is something that you know something about, it's certainly worth sharing. We all like history. We all like to know where people came from. Josh gave a great speech when he was working on his Competent Communicator Manual about his DNA results and his ancestry. It's fascinating. It's fascinating to a lot of people because we all have that common history with our families. It may not always be fantastic necessarily, but that's a topic in personal experience that you can use to draw topics from is your education. What stories do you have from your educational experience? What teachers do you remember being terrible and mean and pushing you to your limit and making you stretch and get things done? And then realizing years later, that was the best teacher I ever had. How can you use your education to educate others? There are so many topics in education. And educating others is something that personally I am passionate about and that I enjoy. That's my comfort zone. If I give a speech all about myself, I'm less comfortable than if I am sharing information with people that are looking for information. So education is a great opportunity and a great arena to choose your speech topic from. Then the next big bucket that I mentioned is reference material. So if you don't have any experiences, you are all adults in this room and you've had zero experiences worth sharing. Right? We're all just the most boring people ever, and we have no stories, no experiences. There's plenty of reference material. You are only one click or one library visit away from a speech topic. I think we have all been around the internet long enough to know that there is a website for everything. So whatever you might be interested in, or whatever you may want to speak about, cruise around the internet for 10 minutes, clicking around, and you can find a topic. You can find something that you react to, that makes you think, that you realize you could develop a speech around. So websites and the internet are the first area of reference material that you can pull a speech topic from. The next is a personal favorite of mine, and it is books. So if you have read anything that's really good recently, tell people about it so those people can read it. Like I said earlier, if it was garbage, you gotta warn the world. This is important. Magazines are another source, and Toastmasters members receive a monthly Toastmaster magazine in the mail when you join the organization. There are endless amounts of topics in there that are focused on communication. They're actually focused on public speaking. So you can get really, really meta with your topic when you get in there, but there are endless amounts of topics in there. There are also trade magazines. There are, I just recently read an article in the Smithsonian, and it was about the history of epidemics and vaccines and that whole process over centuries. Could I write a speech about that topic? Yeah, I could. I read that article and I could use that. I could use that as a source material. And then finally, and this one may be a little bit touchy right now for many people, but finally is the news. That is a reference material that you can use to draw speech topics from. So when's the last time you read something that was in the newspaper that you had a reaction to, or a thought about, or something to say about? That can be a speech topic. What's going on in our community right now? What do the local papers say about what's going on and what the selectmen are doing? That can be a speech topic. Editorials, that's a whole arena of opinions that you can agree with strongly or you can disagree with. You can form an entire speech based on your opinion of someone else's opinion. Even just news in general, not any specific news, you can talk about the news. You can talk about whether you think it's fake, how much bias is there in the media, and how can you tell if there's bias. So those are four different areas of reference material that you can pull from. As I said, personal experience is another one. But then, how many artists are in the room? Anybody consider themselves a free thinker? All right, this is good. This is good. Because sometimes we get inspired by things. And when you get inspired, that means that something pops in your head and aha, that's my speech topic. The trick that I have for you when it comes to using your inspiration is to make sure that you capture it. It might not be an opportune time to write a whole speech. You might not be able to make an outline with a very clear opening, middle, and conclusion. But you can take that idea, you can write it down, and you can come back to it later. So if you are inspired, make sure to capture that. Now, I have given you a very large overflow of ideas for your speech topics. So what do you do with this overwhelming amount of things to speak about? You're going to need to narrow it down. I have four steps here. I have four steps to narrowing it down. The first is your audience. Consider your audience. Who are you speaking to? So let's say that you have a moment of inspiration and you really want to talk about the Justin Bieber concert that you went to. Is the senior center the place to give that speech?
Probably.
Maybe. It could be enlightening, it could be enlightening, you're right. However, it might not be the appropriate audience. So you need to consider the demographics of your audience that you're addressing and make sure that your topic is going to be relevant and make sure that your topic is going to match up with the demographic and your audience. You also need to consider what your audience may or may not already know. You wouldn't want to stand in front of a group of people and tell them everything they're already aware of because they will be bored and they will stop listening. So make sure you consider that. You don't want to go to the high school and do a presentation on the ins and outs and nitty gritty of electrical engineering. It's not probably going to land well. You could talk about the possibilities for careers and educational opportunities in science and physics and the idea that that is an option for these students. The next is the occasion or the event that you are speaking about. If you're going to narrow down your speaking topics, think about why you're speaking. What is the purpose of this event and this scenario? Toastmasters will listen to any topic. We are here for you to talk about whatever it is you need to talk about. However, if you are speaking at an awards luncheon for a specific organization, there are probably programming topics that you need to cover and make sure that you pay attention to. The next way to narrow it down is to think about your ability and your knowledge in the arena of the topic that you chose. Are there any blanks you need to fill in order to really make your ideas sound? Do you even care enough about this topic to present it with conviction? If you don't, scrap it. Get a new idea. Because the thing that will carry the best will be something that you actually have conviction and care about and want to communicate to other people. You also need to consider your credentials in your ability and your knowledge. And this is really good because this helps you build your confidence. If you ask yourself the question in your head, am I qualified to talk to people about this? You're going to have to acknowledge that the answer is yes. And if you're not, you're gonna backtrack and find a better topic that works better, that you do have authority about. And then finally, to narrow it down, you need to be specific. So, you've gone through, you've decided, my audience would like this topic. You've said, this event totally fits. And I'm qualified, and I have the ability to speak about this thing. Narrow it down further. Be specific, because naturally, if you fine-tune and you narrow your focus, the structure of your speech will naturally follow and will naturally be more organized. The more specific you can be, rather than broad and over here in the topic, and then a little bit of this part of the topic, and then some of this part of the topic, those elements will come through. So the more focused that you are, the stronger structure that your speech will have. So there are endless amounts of potential topics to choose from. And if you ever get stuck when you're trying to come up with one, you can pull from your personal experience in a number of ways. You can talk about your family, you can talk about your interests, or you can go to the internet, you can read a book, and find some reference material, and pull a topic from there. The good news is, for our speech prep participants, is your first speech is called the icebreaker. The topic is already given to you. So remember these ideas for the next time around, when you will actually have to choose a topic that is not yourself and your own introduction. So I hope this educational session has been helpful to everybody. There are a lot of resources and areas that we can pull our topics from. And later in the meeting, we'll assign everybody advisors. And if you have further questions about it or further detailed questions, you can work with your advisor. Or we're all here, we're all willing to help all those masters. That's kind of what the whole thing's about. So good luck in choosing your topics, and good luck in your icebreakers, which is chosen.